And when we get rid of those things, those things are what's holding us back for living our truest selves, our full lives, right? So to hit on what Ken said, our unfinished projects, yes, those add a lot of our stress. So if an intention could be, I'm going to finish what I start this year, let's not add something new until you finish up something new, something you've already started. Part of that is setting our goals. Now, in goal setting, the purpose of a goal is not to finish what you started. The purpose of a goal is to grow, okay? Setting that, getting at, pushing ourselves to do something that's out of our comfort zone a little bit, that makes us, try something new, do something a little bit differently, that is the purpose of a goal. What the result is wonderful. If you added more vegetables and exercise into your diet, it decreased the sugar, got rid of the sugar and the high fats, high bad fats, the result would be that you lose some weight, you get healthy. But that may not be the true goal that you're motivated by. A lot of people will say, I need to lose some weight. But when you dig a little deeper, why do you believe that? What are you going to get when you do that? Do you get to spend more quality time with your family? Do you get to play on the floor and roll around with the kids? Do you get to run that 5K that you've been thinking about? What is it that you're going to get when you do that thing? So what I want to talk to you, another thing is being emotionally connected to the things that we want. When you're emotionally connected to your goal, when you're emotionally connected to the intention that you put out into the universe, it starts to attract. You start to attract it, and it starts to attract you. You think about it. You feel what it would be like. I'm gonna share something a little personal. I released 17 pounds this past year. Got a little bit more, but I released it. I let it go. I've been holding on to it for a long time. And I didn't understand. I kept saying, I wanna lose weight. But when I put that out of my mind and I focused on getting healthy, on what it would feel like to get healthy, I want to be fit, I want to be healthy, I want to look good in pictures, I want to look good up on stage when I talk to people. That's what I focused on. I didn't focus on the weight. Okay? And so it made it easier to skip the cookie, to not cheat on the plan I was on, to drink more water. It made me feel good. And as I started to see the weight, though, which was bonus, right, is I stopped all pain medication in my back. I can now walk and run without pain in my knees. There's so much more that I'm like, wow, that is a great result. That is something that I want, which then makes me want to do more healthy eating, more exercise. When we get emotionally connected to the things that we want, whether it be a new job, a new body, a new relationship, that's what's going to fuel you to keep going. That said, and I want you all to really pay attention to, I want to be on time. How we say our goal is very important. You didn't say, I don't want to be late. You said, I want to be on time. That's the same thing. Could be construed as the same thing, but it's not. One is a negative, and one is a positive. So be very, very conscious of the words that you use. Because are you sending out a negative message, or are you sending out a positive message? This morning on my coaching call, one lady said, I just wish I had more money. I want more money. Well, a couple of things there. Number one is, what do you want the money for? What is the intention of having the more money? Okay. Second is, by saying you want it, means you don't have it. So, and what is the universe? What does God say? Yes. It always says yes. We are always manifesting that which we want. And if that's what you're putting out there, you're saying yes. You can have that. You can have more money. You can have, I don't have any money. But if you said, I have enough money in my life, I have enough positive relationships in my life, what am I going to do with all of this money in my life? What am I going to do with all these people who love and adore me? Now, number one, you may not hear it. When you hear it, you may not believe it at first. You may say, that sounds kind of funny to say out loud, right? But if you tell yourself that every day, every morning that you wake up, throughout the day, if you tell yourself a lie enough, you will start to believe it. If you say, I can't dance, I don't know how to dance, you are going to go out there and look funny because you're not going to have the confidence nor the ability nor believe that you can go out there on the dance floor and kick it up, right? But if you believe that, if you tell yourself enough that, hey, yeah, I can dance, and not only on top of that, then you take action on that and go sign up for a class, and you see each week that you go, you commit to going, you commit to trying what they're proposing you do, you practice, the next thing you know, the I can't dance person of 2015 turns into a I can rock it on the dance floor in 2016. We can do this with anything in our lives. It doesn't matter what area. It doesn't matter if it's work, if it's play, if it's our love lives. Tracy mentioned the synapses in our brains. And a lot of what we talk about when we talk about manifesting, I don't know what you guys believe or what you've heard or what you know about it, but we do. It's a neural process. It's the spiritual side of us moving into the physical side of us. And when I say that, is everything is made of molecules, which are in motion. Our atoms are always in motion. Everything is vibrating in motion. And those synapses are our thoughts. Our thoughts are motion. They're thought action. Okay? Those thoughts enter our brain. We think about it. We have a feeling to that. We add a feeling. It either makes us feel good or makes us feel bad. And that's what gets us to do what we want, what we do. And it could cause you to, if you think, I'm gonna stay healthy and motivated and focused because at the end of the year, I want to take my kids on a 12-mile mountain hike, camping trip. That the trip is the goal. And she's going to lay out her intention of what she needs to do for that goal. And then it's not going to all happen at once. It's telling herself over and over, that's my goal. What do I need to do? What's next? Those synapses cut as we get older, we tell ourselves we can't do something, or we've been told we can't do something, and so we cut it off. But every time we do something new, we talk about brain function, switching your left hand to your right hand. Anytime you think something new, anytime you act and do something new, it's creating a new path in your brain. And that new path, you know, it's like taking your first time down a road, and you take a new way that you go, oh, I didn't know I could get here this way. But are you going to remember it for the next time? You have to consciously remember it until it becomes a habit the next time. And the idea is switching it up and making those habits new habits. Habit is done because you've done it over and over and over and over and over again. Your parents didn't tell you your name one time. Say, little Tracy, I'm going to tell you your name one time and you have to remember it. I might tell you again next year, but you got to remember it. No, it was because we were constantly told this. Everything we believe, everything we think about ourselves, about the world around us, is because we were told or we've accepted that to be true. So if you don't like what you see out here, if your intention for this year, you have great big intentions, figure out why those are your intentions. Figure out what's motivating you. What is it in your heart that you're connecting to? Can you get emotionally connected to that intention? Because it's going to be a whole lot easier to stay focused on that, doing what you have to do to make that true. Again, I'm going to tap on you. Meditation. You wake up every day, and you set your intention for the day, even start the night before for what you want the next day, but get your brain working on what you want. Then the next morning you wake up, you say it again, and then you know what? You've fueled yourself for what's going to happen that day. And it's going to be a whole lot easier to go about and face what's going to be coming at you that day. So our happiness is driven by our inner desires. Connect to those inner desires, and then your life can really become magical. So I hope each and every one of you have a tremendous, fun time figuring out what your intentions are going to be for 2016, and I wish you all the best in attaining.